So now we want to talk about expected value, and let's start with an example. There's a game that you're considering playing. You pay $1 for a ticket to roll a six-sided die. If you roll a 1, a 2, a 3, or a 6, you lose. If you roll a 4, you get your money back. But if you roll a 5, you win $4. What is the expected value of playing this game? And what this phrase, expected value, means? At least in this example, it means the average amount of money you expect to gain or lose by playing this game per roll in the long run. To answer this question, it might be best to make a chart. And in this chart, we're going to list the event that happens, the probability that that event happens, and the net gain from that event happening. So we're rolling a die, so the possibilities are rolling a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, a 5, and a 6. The probability of each one of those events happening, if this die is fair, is 1/6. There are 6 possible outcomes, so the probability of any individual outcome is just going to be 1 out of 6. Now, about the net gain. With this game, if we roll a 1, a 2, a 3, or a 6, we lose, so we lose a dollar. So in the row for rolling a 1, a 2, a 3, and a 6, I'm going to put a net gain of minus $1. If you roll a 4, you'll notice you get your money back, so there's no gain or loss there. And if you roll a 5, you win $4, but notice that you paid a dollar, so our net gain is actually just $3 there. Now, to calculate our expected value, we're going to take every probability in this table and multiply it by the net gain in that table. For example, for this first row rolling a 1, we're going to take 1/6 and multiply that by negative 1. We're going to do this in every single row, and we're going to add all of our results together, and that number is going to be our expected value. If we do this, we get negative 1/6, or we can get a decimal of negative 0.16667. That is the expected value of playing this game. Now let's interpret it. Well, what this means is that on average, in the long run, we expect to lose $0.1666 each time we play. That corresponds to 16.6 cents lost every time we play this game. Now, obviously, we will never lose exactly 16.6 cents in any given play of this game. We can either lose a dollar or gain $3. But what this means is, if we play this game, say, 100 times, we should expect to lose about $16 to $17 by playing this game. So we might say that this game is unfair because the people who play it are expected to lose. So a question we might ask is, what would be a fair price for this particular game? Well, we paid $1 for our ticket, and given that we're paying $1 for our ticket, our expected value is to lose 16.6 cents per play. So it might make sense that if we take that $1 fee for playing this game and subtract off the 16 cents that we expect to lose, that we might get a fair price for this game. And that would be correct. The fair price for this game is $0.8333, or about 83 cents. And in general, the fair price for a game can be given by this formula. We just take the current cost to play the game, add on to that the expected value, and you get yourself the fair price for playing that game. Okay, let's do a couple more examples. Here's an example. A concert venue expects 10,000 people to attend if it doesn't rain, and 2,000 people to attend if it does rain. The chance of rain is 60%. What is the expected attendance? So we could make a table for this. There are 2 possible outcomes. Either it rains or it doesn't. The probability of rain is said to be 60%, which we can write as 0.6. That means that the probability that it doesn't rain is 0.4, or 40%. The result if it rains is 2,000 people, and the result if it doesn't rain is 10,000 people. To calculate the expected value, we take each result and multiply it by its corresponding probability. We add those answers together, and when I do that, I get 5,200 attendees. Now that is the answer. Let's interpret it. Well, what we just found was that in the long run, under these conditions, we expect an average of 5,200 concertgoers per concert. Now again, obviously, you're never going to have exactly 5,200 concertgoers. We're assuming we're either going to get 10,000 or 2,000. But on average, given that there's a 60% chance of rain, we should expect 5,200 concertgoers in the long run. Okay, let's do one more example. We have a spinner, and a person spins the wheel and is rewarded the amount indicated by the pointer. What is the expected value of a spin? Again, I think it makes sense to make a chart. We need 2 things in the chart. We need probability, and we need how much we're winning or losing. So the idea from this drawing is that you should have a 50-50 chance to win $6. Because if this is a fair spinner, 50% of the spins will land on this $6 half of the pie. So we gain $6 one half of the time. You could also call this 0.5. Now, the way I intended to draw this was to show that 1/4 of the time we're going to lose $2, and 1/4 of the time we're going to lose $7. Again, to find the expected value, we multiply each of our probabilities by our net gain or loss, we add those results up, and we get an answer. I'm getting an expected value of 0.75. Let's interpret that result. Well, an expected value of 0.75 says that on average, we expect to win 75 cents per spin. Obviously, on any given spin, you will never win exactly 75 cents. But if you spin this thing a whole bunch of times, on average, that's our expectation. Okay, I think that's going to do it for this section. I will see y'all in the next one.